Welcome to this portion of the worship at Daleville Christian Church. This is the Word of God portion of the worship. You do not see the singing portions, the praise portions, the prayer portions, or the Jesus' communion table portions of the service. Those all take place regularly at Daleville Christian Church during the worship service. May you find this portion uplifting, as ever our Lord would direct by His Holy Spirit. We always use an affirmation of our faith in the worship, and this one is from Ephesians in the second chapter. But because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgression. It is by grace you have been saved, through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God. The reading of God's word for today is from the letter called 1 Timothy, from the Apostle to Timothy, the first chapter beginning in verse 3 through verse 7. As I urged you when I went into Macedonia, stay there in Ephesus, so that you may command certain people not to teach false doctrines any longer, or to devote themselves to myths and endless genealogies. Such things promote controversial speculations, rather than advancing God's work, which is faith. The goal of this command is love, which comes from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith. Some have departed from these and have turned to meaningless talk. They want to be teachers of the law, but they do not know what they are talking about or what they confidently affirm. May the Lord add His blessing to this reading of His holy word. So this month of October, we're beginning the process of preparation for my leave-taking, my retirement is on the calendar. And we're beginning that process of preparation first by talking about it. We're not denying it. We're not avoiding it. One of the best things to do when looking forward to a succession of leadership is to plan for it. We're beginning the planning process by talking about it. Jesus prepared the disciples for His own leave-taking twice. Certainly, I should do no less than what our Lord Jesus did. Last week, I mentioned that I believe that you need remember you are not going to replace me in this pulpit right here. No one should ever be told they are a replacement for someone else. In the army, it's okay to be a replacement, but the word replacement denies the individuality of the person who is called a replacement. It also puts a big burden on them. I cannot be replaced. I am irreplaceable. But remember, mutants are irreplaceable. I'm not saying I'm a mutant, but I am just pointing out that I am a unique individual, as God has made each of us unique individuals. There isn't anyone like you in all of human history. There has never been another you at any time, anywhere else in the world. It is apparently a part of God's plan. So, it is unfair to replace me. Unfair to the next lead pastor of Daleville Christian Church. I also warned you last week about hiring a celebrity pastor. Don't do it. I mentioned somewhere that I know of 9 high profile pastors. They all crashed and burned one way or another. Some of these very capable and excellent pastors failed in very tragic ways. They were certainly celebrities in the churches they served. The number of people they served numbered into the thousands. You and I can think of others in our lifetimes. Some I've mentioned recently, like Jim and Tammy Faye Baker. But I may be getting ahead of myself. These crashes remind us of an old saying, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. It's another warning about hiring a celebrity pastor. I saw an article on Joel Osteen, pastor of Lakewood Church in Houston, Texas, reportedly the largest Protestant church in America. Joel Osteen is introduced in this article that I read as Texas celebrity pastor Joel Osteen. The word celebrity is almost a part of his name. So here's something to notice. We're celebrating at Daleville Christian Church over 60,000 sermon downloads. Remember, we celebrated 25,000 a year ago. The pandemic has driven people to find God's word at Daleville Christian Church and at Daleville Christian Church's website. I remind you, I don't have my own website. Joel Osteen has his own website. The sermons from Daleville Christian Church are downloaded from Daleville Christian Church's website for free. If there is no Daleville Christian Church, there is no website, and there are no pastor sermons available for download. Daleville Christian Church's website is a .org, .org extension. The .org extension means that the church is a nonprofit. Joel Osteen's own personal website is a .com for commercial enterprises. Even Lakewood Church's website is a .com website. Daleville Christian Church's messages are free. You may purchase Joel Osteen's books at his website. Now, we have a donate button on the website and on our Facebook page. We rarely make an appeal for gifts, but as I recall, we have only ever received a couple of gifts from any appeal we have made. Some church people use the donate button for regular offerings, but based on gifts from outside the church, Daleville Christian Church will remain a nonprofit website. So Lakewood Church is a church, and Daleville Christian Church is a church. But they are very different. Joel Osteen is a pastor, or has celebrity pastor as his title. Pastor Gary McManus uses pastor with his name also. But how the word pastor applies to both of them, I could not begin to guess. I mentioned a couple of weeks ago that our Lord Jesus' call to us was for us to pray about leadership, about finding those who would do the harvesting in God's harvest fields. Matthew 9, 37 and 38, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few, said our Lord Jesus. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. You and I at Daleville Christian Church can start praying now for the next lead pastor for Daleville Christian Church. I'm here this morning to remind you to be careful what you pray for. Sometimes church people have a picture in their minds of the perfect pastor. If your picture of the perfect pastor is Texas celebrity pastor Joel Osteen, I'm begging you to change the image in your head. Remember, the perfect pastor does not exist on this side of heaven. Beware of what you have in mind as the person to be the next lead pastor at Daleville Christian Church. Be careful what you pray for, and I'll show you what I mean. Do you want your next lead pastor to be a knight in shining armor? Is that reference too old? Is that reference too fairy tale for you? Well, if you've thought that Daleville Christian Church needs a knight in shining armor, be sure to include in your prayers that it never rains. The knight in shining armor's armor will corrode and rust. That pastor will have a hard time getting to worship on a rainy Sunday morning. Oh, the knight in shining armor pastor will need a valet or butler. You can't put armor pants on one leg at a time by yourself. But maybe you would rather look for the man on the white horse. Now, you have to be at least my age to know that reference. But we start with the Western fiction character Hopalong Cassidy, begun in 1904, but portrayed on screen for nearly 20 years by the actor William Boyd. In almost 140 films and TV shows, Hopalong Cassidy rode his trusty horse, Topper, a white stallion. Next is the Lone Ranger Western fiction character, a crime fighter. First was radio for 1,300 episodes, then television for 9 years, which then started comic books and several films. His horse, Silver, also white. And Silver's stunt double, a horse named Traveler, became University of Southern California's mascot. That started in 1961. So ever since 1961, when the football team of the University of Southern California scores a home team touchdown, the whole stadium sees a triumphant white horse circle the stadium. The horse got his own statue at USC in 2010. I could go on. Roy Rogers' horse, Trigger, was a Palomino, but not white. Roy and Trigger were in 81 films and 100 television shows. Dale Evans' horse was considered a buckskin color. The horse's name? Buttermilk. Certainly before color television, the horses would seem to be white. I only mention all this because it shows how ingrained the image of a hero on a white horse is in our American culture. It would be easy for any one of us to picture a hero figure on a white horse coming to Daleville Christian Church's rescue. Even though horse culture is long gone. So why not a pastor on a white horse? Well, if you're in a movie, it would be okay. But we're not in a movie or a television program. This is real life. In real life, riding to the rescue, your white hat could fly off. Your white horse could get dirty in the mud. The hero still might not arrive on time. It would really help if your hero pastor on a white horse was a horse whisperer. Although I've never heard of even one pastor who was a horse whisperer. Also, it would help if the hero pastor on a white horse was a good shot with a revolver, if they still make them. Yes, they still make revolvers, and some professionals still use them. But find a pastor riding a white horse who's a good shot with one. And even if the pastor can ride and shoot, can the pastor also preach? So even if a pastor on a white horse rides up to Daleville Christian Church in answer to your prayers, make sure you have a lot of interview questions ready. Don't ask that pastor to ride around Daleville. Ask that pastor to preach. Okay, a couple of more prayer requests you might make. How about praying for King Midas or the goose that lays the golden egg to be your next pastor? With either King Midas or that goose, money would flow into Daleville Christian Church. The church would have no money problems. Ever. Except what to do with all the money. I actually know of a small church that had acquired a large endowment. The church eventually got down to one person. That person didn't want to close the church. Fortunately, it was a denominational church, and the denomination stepped in and closed the church. But as I've told you before, churches that bring in a lot of money wind up having expensive and/or celebrity pastors. We covered that already. Also, all that money starts to look like the pastor's money to the pastor. That's why one church in Texas was shut down and the pastor and his wife went into counseling. Church money went to ATVs and expensive restaurants and designer clothes. You know what happened to King Midas. Pastor King Midas will eventually turn you into gold. I don't know all your dreams for your life, but becoming a precious metal yourself probably isn't one of them. I just read a website on 15 fallen pastors, many names you would recognize. For example, Jim Baker. If Jim Baker was the goose that laid the golden eggs, and he and his then wife, Tammy Faye Baker, certainly were making gold. If Jim Baker was the golden goose, no one was watching the hen house. Would you like Superman to be your pastor? Remember what Superman does. Superman fights crime. He can leap buildings in a single bound, bend steel in his bare hands, and is more powerful than a locomotive. Superman is a man of action. Superman does not make speeches or sermons. I've never seen Superman portrayed as praying. If Superman fights crime on Sunday morning, Superman won't be in worship to lead worship. So do you want Superman as your pastor? Perhaps it would be better if Clark Kent were your pastor. I can easily imagine Clark Kent coming to worship and writing sermons. I'll bet that Clark Kent would visit you in the hospital. Don't look for Superman to visit you in the hospital. I thought that I read that Superman performed surgery once, but Superman didn't visit the patient. Maybe you're hoping that Clark Kent and Superman would be the same person. Yes, and that's a problem. They can't be in the same room at the same time. Only Clark Kent would show up for worship. That's my point. Maybe you don't want to pray that the Lord sends Superman to be your next pastor at Daleville Christian Church. What has this to do with God's word? Plenty. The first churches had leadership problems. We talked last week about some leaders who considered themselves super apostles. The Apostle Paul considered them troublemakers, agitators. The Apostle Paul did not accept the so-called superiority of the super apostles. Not at all. Here in 1 Timothy, we read of more leadership problems in Jesus' churches. 1 Timothy chapter 1. Command certain people not to teach false doctrines any longer, or to devote themselves to myths and endless genealogies. Such things promote controversial speculations rather than the advancing of God's work. So the apostle wants Timothy to confront the teachers of false doctrines and myths. and their pedigree. Then the apostle adds, the goal of this command is love, which comes from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith. So that is what should be taught. Sincere faith, which comes by faith from a pure heart and a good conscience. And the apostle can emphasize this because he has seen what happened if you forsake the command of love. Verse 6. Some have departed from these and have turned to meaningless talk. They want to be teachers of the law, but they do not know what they are talking about or what they so confidently affirm. The apostle gives examples in the same chapter in verse 19. Holding on to faith and good conscience, which some have rejected, and so have suffered shipwreck of their faith, among them Hymenaeus and Alexander, whom I have handed over to Satan to be taught not to blaspheme. I've preached and taught about these guys, Hymenaeus, Alexander. They're put out of the church, excommunicated. That's how they are handed over to Satan. They no longer have the church's protection from evil. But it isn't punishment that they are put out. They are excommunicated for the purpose of being reformed. It's the reform school of Satan which will make you want to come back to the church. Facing evil on your own in the world will make you want to reconcile with the church. So the apostle states that everyone, including teachers and leaders, can avoid this trouble. Those two teachers, Hymenaeus and Alexander, were pure as driven snow, but in the words of the late great actress Mae West, they drifted. That's what the apostle says, right? The apostle ends his letter with emphasis on the pastor leader's duty. Because we have put our hope in the living God, who is the Savior of all people, and especially of those who believe. Set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Until I come, devote yourself to the public reading of Scripture, to preaching, and to teaching. There, Daleville Christian Church, there is your next pastor, your next lead pastor. Not a crime fighter, or a moneymaker, or a celebrity, or a celebrity hero. You want a pastor devoted to God's Word. Devoted to preaching and teaching. And Daleville Christian Church, never forget that the first heroes of the church, the apostles, when the going got tough in Jesus' last days, they all ran away. They forsook Jesus and fled. They forsook Jesus and fled when hours before they claimed they would follow Jesus to the death. Those men are the church's heroes. But they were forgiven and found the grace to forgive themselves, to become the apostles we want to remember. This command is love, which comes from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith. Amen.